Recognize any of these places? We often think of them as wild spaces for people to explore and enjoy. But they're also safe spaces for nature to thrive. Protecting natural lands and waters like these is a key way to slow biodiversity loss and ease the effects of climate change. We know that, and we're trying to do more of it. In fact, Canada has already conserved over 2 million square kilometers of its land and marine areas, and we're trying to increase that number as quickly as we can. This is good news, but protecting more lands and more waters is just one piece of the puzzle. For protected places to be fully effective at conserving nature, we need to make sure species can safely access what they need to survive. And sometimes those things are beyond the boundaries of a protected area. So what can we do?
I think when I first started working at parks, I really imagined borders to be this very obvious thing, like a fence, but species don't see that division.
This is Dr. Liz Nelson. She's an expert in conservation planning at Parks Canada.
Species on land, in the water, and in the air travel to mate, give birth, find food, and disperse their seeds.
And species will move in and out of the park many times through their lifetime, often many times during the day.
Take this example. Scientists at Natural Resources Canada tracked a herd of caribou around Grosmore National Park for more than a year. You can see that the caribou spend plenty of time moving between Gros Morne and a nearby provincial park. Allowing this sort of free-flowing movement is exactly what we're trying to do.
Even when we plan protected areas to provide this safe haven for species and ecosystems we care about, we have to recognize that those species and ecosystems are always moving in and out of those spaces, and we want to create space across larger landscapes to really give them the best chance of survival.
The idea that connectivity is important isn't new, by the way. Movement and connection have always been an integral part of Indigenous knowledge systems. Aside from allowing access to basic necessities, unimpeded movement inside and outside of protected areas is critical for genetic exchange between populations. It also gives species space to move and adapt to changing climate conditions, which is only going to become more necessary. When we block connections, we create problems for species and ecosystems. Ocean traffic, dams, roadways, agricultural lands, and fenceways are all examples of barriers that inhibit species movement and the flow of natural processes. When we build these things, we're left with these small fragments of natural landscapes, isolating species who rely on movement to survive. So, really, what can we do? Our goal is to keep ecosystems connected, both within and outside of protected areas. We can't turn back time, but we can restore connections between habitats that have been lost and maintain the ones that remain. And those connections can come in all shapes and sizes. At Parks Canada, we're building highway overpasses and underpasses that help species across safely. We're restoring connections between protected areas and other habitat by supporting ecological corridors. We're removing human infrastructure that limits movements and natural flows, like old fences, dams, and power lines. We're learning from Indigenous knowledge holders how cultural and ecological connections to the landscape are weaved together. We're restoring creek channels and natural water flows for species at risk. We're also working with universities, conservation groups, and other governments to track species movements so we can prioritize new areas to protect and confirm if existing connections are being used. The land that connects natural spaces is managed by all sorts of different individuals and organizations, meaning no one group can tackle the challenge of connectivity alone. We need to think beyond boundaries and beyond borders, municipal, provincial, federal, even continental. To protect nature, it needs to be connected, and we need to work together. Find out more about how Parks Canada is connecting landscapes for conservation at the link on your screen.